This video presents the tone mapping rendering post effect feature of the R19 CineRender engine, built into ARCHICAD, developed by Maxon. When creating a rendering, it is possible that parts of the rendered image look underexposed on the screen. In other words, some parts of the rendered image are too dark, while other parts of the image look overexposed, that is, too bright. The reason for this is that the rendering engine in the background uses 32-bit color depth, while the monitor screen is only able to display 8-bit color depth. So, the rendering engine would never create a fully under- or overexposed image. However, the display technology of the screen allows only a limited depth of color to be displayed. 8 bits per channel means that there are only 256 color depth-related bits of information to be seen on the screen. CineRender's tone mapping functionality helps to overcome such issues using advanced algorithms. Let's display the Advanced Settings panel of the Photo Rendering Settings dialog and display the HDR Image tab page. When we use the High Dynamic Range background image for the rendered scene, it is difficult to foresee the range of highlights and underexposed areas of the final render. In such rendering cases, it is recommended to switch on the Tone Mapping option. This is available from the Effects container. The operator options define the applied algorithm. There are 5 operator options to choose from. These are Linear, Photolinear, Autolinear, Max White, and Reinhard 02. Each operator has various adjustable options. Let's select the Max White operator. This has the simplest settings. Here you can see the results of the Max White tone mapping operator on the final rendered image. This operator simply pushes the brightest rendered value towards the left so that it can be displayed on the screen. Please notice the results on the screen. The sky in the background is not burned out anymore, and details of the clouds around the sun are noticeable. However, please also notice that the lower part of the rendered image is darker than before. The Max White operator should be used only in certain relevant rendering cases. Let's see the characteristics of the Linear Tone Mapping operator. This provides more detailed setting options. Using the Scale option, it's possible to define how the overexposed range should be handled in the displayed image. This operator, as its name also suggests, uses linear algorithms. Similarly to the Max White operator, the underexposed areas will also be darker. Let's switch to the Autolinear Tone Mapping operator. Here, the algorithm automatically adjusts the range of overexposed areas, while the tone of the underexposed areas are closer to the original render. This is due to the adjustable gamma value. The higher the gamma value, the brighter the midtones of the rendered image will be. The Autolinear Tone Mapping operator is a good choice for a wide range of rendering scenarios. This operator results in a rendered image with adequate level of detail. Let's select the Photolinear Tone Mapping operator. The gamma value can also be entered, similarly to the Autolinear operator. Besides the gamma, the exposure, ISO, and f-stop values can also be modified, similarly to a real photography camera with interchangeable lens and manual settings. This operator is recommended to fine-tune a previously rendered image. The last, and perhaps the most interesting, tone mapping operator is called Reinhard 02. This is based on industry standard algorithms. Here we can define pre-scale and post-scale values. Using pre-scale, we can lighten up the lower dark tones, and using post-scale, we can darken the higher bright tones on the render image. It is also possible to define a burn value. This can be used to burn out certain tones of the image. Using the Reinhard 02 tone mapping operator, we can achieve HDR, that is, high dynamic range, like renderings. In other words, we can create images that do not have too dark or too bright areas. For instance, the front entrance of this building may be even a bit lighter than the original upper image, while the clouds near the sun also have some details. Please note that the rendered images should be saved as TIFF using high accuracy color with alpha channel to preserve the full dynamic range of tone mapping. TIFF image format contains 32-bit color information about every channel. This practically means that no color information will be lost, and any image post-processing can be used for further enhancements. Let's see an example of the possible rendering results if the content of the model changes between the renderings. Here you can see the result of this simple model without using tone mapping. Please notice that the sky in the background is burned out, meaning that it is too bright, and not all the details of the clouds are visible. Let's add some artificial light sources to the project, and add some LED panels to the columns as well. Rendering the scene without tone mapping would result in a completely overexposed or burned out image. Not only the details of the clouds in the sky, but also the surface finish of the walls disappeared. Let's use tone mapping for the next rendering. We will select the auto linear operator. This is the best operator choice if the content of the model is changing. First, let's render the original scene without the light sources and the LED panels. Here is the rendered image using tone mapping. Please notice that the sky in the background is not overexposed and the details of the clouds are visible. Here is the original render without tone mapping. Let's see now what happens if we use tone mapping for the second scene that has additional light sources. And here is the resulting image using tone mapping. The differences are outstanding. All the pixels of the rendered image are visible, meaning that none of the pixels are too bright or too dark. Please note that the illumination effect of the spotlights are much more significant than the effect of the fireplace. Let's see another example. We will re-render the original scene without spotlight and LED panels. Let's use tone mapping this time. But let's select another HDR background photo instead of the previously used sky photo. Let's render this scene now. Please remember that tone mapping is a post-rendering effect. This means that this is applied at the end of the rendering process. You don't need to worry if you see some overexposed area while the rendering is in progress. The effect of tone mapping will be visible at the end. The rendering process is getting ready. And now the tone mapping post-rendering effect is also applied. CineRender's tone mapping feature helps architects to create renderings without under- or overexposed parts in the image.